Susquehanna 2222. Say, he's been in there over an hour.
What are you getting nervous about? When Shemp pours on the charm, no dame can resist him.
I hope you're right.
Hello? Is this Ginger Gray? It is? Well, this is your little Snookums. I'm about to do you a big favor. Will you marry me?
Oh. Hey, any luck? I've got one phone number and one nickel left. Well, start using it. You clumsy ox, you. Where'd that go?
It went down here someplace.
Let's find it. Take it over that side. Take this receiver.
I got it.
All right, just take it.
Wait a minute.
All right.
Now, wait. Get this out of my hair here.
All right.
Easy. Get off your foot. Look at what I got here.
What is that?
One of those. Yeah, wait a minute. It leads around under my arm, then up here around the neck.
That's your...
Get your hand out of here.
All right.
Easy.
All right. Now, wait a minute.
Can you dial from there?
No, can you?
Yeah. Wait a minute. If I come around like this one and get up in this one,
how's that?
Well, it don't feel as good as when I did this.
Oh, wait. Take it easy. Now, look. We ain't getting no place fast.
Let's get at this thing right the right way. You want to get this off.
All right, wait a minute.
All right.
Can't stand it anymore.
It started with the book, didn't it?
Mo, where's your hat?
How you doing?
Get your hand out of my face.
That ain't my hand, that's your hand.
All right, you asked for it.
Wait. Say, miss, would you like to get married?
What?
Get married?
Well, I don't know, but you are kind of cute at that.
Oh, it's not me, it's him.
You've got to get out of this.
All right.
There isn't much time left. You know that, don't you?
All right.
What happened?
That's what I want to know.
Wait a minute.
Oh, Mo! I'm blind! You point my eye out! Get a towel, Mo!
Okay.
Get a towel!
Hey, where are the towels?
In the bottom drawer.
I got it.
You sure look funny with a Buster Brown collar.
Hold that.
Almost had 7 years for bad luck. Oh. How do you like that?
I said stand still.
Oh. Hey, I cut off my head. Mo, my head is off. Mo, my head is off. Oh. Oh, there I am. And as pretty as a picture.
Yeah, but Nate, get going.
This means $500,000.
I know what it means.
Here you are. Boy, am I tired.
Where'll I throw this water?
You look good. You look great, kid. You're a cinch. Go to it.
Come on.
That's right, dear uncle. If I could make you disappear, I could sell the store and get all the money. All I had to do was blame it on the legend of Vladimir Harstakor.
Which may not be quite the legend you think. I found this postcard Vladimir sent back to his hired help. He vanished, all right. To a bungalow on Miami Beach.
Yeah, well, I still would have gotten away with it if it weren't for you meddling mystery solvers and your Christmas crazy dog!
Only one more mystery. How did you two get the Christmas Glockenspiel to work? It's been broken for years.
We didn't. The guy playing Santa did.
You mean him?
It was a snowman, I tell you! Now get me out of this germ-infested receptacle! I am an actor!
That angry dude wasn't Santa.
Thank you, kids, enough. You saved me and my toy store. Look at all those smiling faces. It's all I ever wanted.
I have to say, Mr. Menkel, we love your toy store, but we love your Santa even more.
There you go, little dude. Now tell Santa Claus everything you want for Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you. And Scooby-Dooby-Doo!
Welcome to our little show. Is everybody on their marks? You look like you might be off your mark, Jimmy. A little bit. See, I'm an exacting host. Let's get ready for a toss-up. Grab those devices. $1,000 at stake. Thing is the category. Vanna's on her mark. Now. And it's Marie.
The winning ticket.
There you go.
Great.
Nothing.
I've actually been here before.
Would you?
I was in the audience when I was like 8 years old.
Oh, did you have a good time?
I did.
Oh, that was a special week we had.
Yes, it was soap opera week.
And were you a soap opera fan? Was that?
My mom was, so I guess I kind of was as well. But I knew who Lisa Rinna was, and she was on the show, and I love her.
Well, that's terrific. Now, I want to say that I don't mean to turn this into a grim moment, but you have been stuck in an elevator, and now you're afraid of them?
Yes.
You go on them?
When I have to, but I like to take the stairs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was once stuck on an escalator for 4 hours. It was traumatizing.
That sounds worse.
I know. It's terrible. I take the stairs, too.
Yeah.
Nice to have you here, buddy.
Thank you.
Dr. Michael Haygood, how are you doing?
I'm good.
From right here in Los Angeles. Michael is a father of five. Is this true?
Yes, I'm the father of five amazing, beautiful, grown adults now.
Yeah, it's funny how they do that.
Yes.
I've got all kinds of titles, a principal, a professor. Which one do you want to talk about? Both of them?
Let's talk about just being there for children. Okay. I came to the planet to be there for kids.
Wow. Army, an Army vet?
I'm a U.S. Army vet.
An umpire?
An umpire in L.A. sports official. I'm exhausted.
You do a lot of things.
I do.
It's good to have you with us.
Thank you so much, Pat.
You do very well. Jimmy Nichols is from Nashville. Yeah. Talk about family a little bit.
Got a beautiful wife, Kim, of 14 years. Two beautiful boys, James and Joseph.
Yeah.
They are 13 and...
$1,000. The category is living thing. Michael.
Bearded collie?
Bobby? Yeah, that's it.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. We're going to do a first-round puzzle here, and the category is same letter. Every word in the puzzle starts with the same letter. An extra $1,000 when you determine what that letter is. And, Michael, because you said bearded collie first, you get to spin first.
Thank you, Pat.
$600.
T.
There are three T's. Not the same letter. I mean, it is the same letter, but not the same letter.
I'd like to buy a vowel.
Mm-hmm.
A.
Four A's.
I'd like to buy another vowel. E.
And here come five E's. Number keeps going up. You still have $1,300.
I'd like to buy another vowel. An I.
You must have seen this show. There are three I's, yeah. $650.
S?
Yep, two S's. Well, after all that work...
Oh!
I know. My sentiments exactly. I'm sorry. Jimmy, a break for you.
All right, let's go.
$900.
R.
There are five R's, and obviously you figured out that same letter. So we'll toss an extra $1,000 in, and that means you have $5,500. $600.
C.
One C. $600.
C.
One C. Boy, the wheel has been cruel here. It wipes your money.
Now, here is the host of Jeopardy, Ken Jennings.
Thank you, Johnny. Welcome to Jeopardy. Our champion, Ray LaLonde, has had to work pretty hard for his last couple of wins with us, but by coming up with the correct response in Final Jeopardy twice, he emerged as champion and now has six Jeopardy wins under his...
Literature, please, for $400.
Honor the charge they made. Honor the blank blank. Noble 600. Rebecca.
What is the Light Brigade? Light Brigade?
Yes.
Literature for 600?
Stay blank, pony boy. Stay blank. Artie.
What is stay gold, pony boy? Stay gold?
You're right.
Lit 800.
The deep and dank tarn at my feet closed sullenly and silently over the fragments of the House of Blank. Rebecca.
What is Usher?
Edgar Allan Poe, you're right.
Literature for 1,000.
It rain harder. Artie.
Who's Prince?
Yes.
A nobility 800.
Remembering the category title, it's where you'll find LaGuardia Airport and, a bit smaller, Alley Pond Environmental Center. Rebecca.
What is Queens?
Yes.
Prepositional phrases for 6.
When singing America the Beautiful, you end with these five words. Ray.
What is Home of the Brave?
No, I'm sorry. Rebecca or Artie? Really not fair to make a Canadian try to do that. From sea to shining sea, in fact. Rebecca?
Let's do prepositional for 4.
IOW is internet...
Your team. Your town. Your terms. Never miss a moment. Watch every game from anywhere. Stream Pacers basketball on Bally Sports Plus. Try it now.
Shorthand for this. A different way to say something. Rebecca?
What is in other words?
You're correct.
Prepositional for 8.
Stuck with two bad options, you're this, the title of a book by trapped climber Aaron Ralston. As he was literally, you're between a rock and a hard place. Back to you, Rebecca.
Let's do sports equipment for 6.
Most of the material used to make the moving objects in this sport comes from a Scottish quarry on Ailsa Craig. Ray.
What is curling?
Yes.
Sports equipment for 800, please.
Some tennis rackets are made with this DuPont product that's also used to make bulletproof vests. We commission you to give the first and last names of this Chief Justice of the United States from 1953 to 1969. Who is Earl Warren? Ray? Anno is a chemistry lecturer from Lambertville, New Jersey. Once had an unfortunate incident during a road trip that I want to hear about.
Yes, we were unpacking at the first campsite and...
Mr. Prosecutor, you have not proved that those men were actually in that chicken coop. Your evidence is purely circumstantial and insufficient to warrant a conviction.
What's he talking about?
Quiet. He means we ain't guilty.
Oh, boy! Dandruff!
And in the future, Officer Kelly, don't come cluttering up this courtroom with flimsy charges against law-abiding citizens. Case dismissed.
Step right up, folks. As you can see, the little lady is in this cabinet. I shall now close the door, and crossing to the other cabinet, I shall fire the magic gun. And what have we in here? The little lady. Magic shot. We have now in here...
Don't tell me.
This is the safest place.
Shut up. There's no room for an argument in here.
Oh, there you are. Let me through here.
Let it go.
Oh! Ah! Ah! Oh! Oh! What the... Well, we're plumbers. Three of the best plumbers that ever plumbed a plum.
Pretty nice joint you got here. Where's the leak, boy?
In the basement.
Where's the basement?
Upstairs.
Up to the basement.
To the basement.
To the basement. Hey, here it is.
Okay, on your toes, men. Not my toes. What do you know about plumbing?
Nothing.
That's fine. Give me a hand.
A simple job for simple people.
How can you fix it while it's leaking?
I wonder why you shut the water off.
I've got an idea.
What is it?
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pail of water. That's it.
That's what?
Water always runs downhill.
On your way.
Where?
Up the hill and shut off the water.
Okay.
Get me a wrench for the pipe. Give it a tap and get things started. What's the matter, Muscles? You're weak? Hit it and find something to wrap around it. Oh!
Hey, look. Straight jacket.
Where did you get that?
Found it in the trunk.
Oh. Well, get it up there. Well, boy. Perfect 36. Hook it up. What do you do with these?
You swing on them, you know?
Like that. Don't you?
Oh!
is a stiff! Why, you lame brain, you! Look what you did to the pipe! Go on, get another piece of pipe!
I resent that!
What are you gonna do about it?
Get another piece of pipe, aren't you? Yeah, hey, no wonder the water don't work. The pipe is plugged up.
This house is sure gone crazy.
If it wasn't for me, where would we be? This thing or else.
Now, friends, I know you'll enjoy a demonstration of my new television receiver. You not only hear the broadcast, but you actually see it on this screen.
Oh, isn't this thrilling? What is all this? What's happening?
It's the plumbers, madam, and they're wrecking the house.
Oh, I'll put a stop to that. I'll call Mr. Casey. Give me...
Give me the torch.
Right.
What's going on here?
It's the plumber, sir. And they've completely wrecked the bathroom.
They have.
Nice job, boys.
You said it. Go up and collect for the job.
What do we got coming?
Who was that? What's the matter with you? Why, you dummy, you ruined our whole day's work.
The judge!
Why, you! Get those men, officer!
Look! Quick, officer, in the hall!
Get those men!
Yes!
Crossing, I shall fire the magic shot. And, opening the door, what have we here? The little...
All the tugs groaned.
Not this morning. Said George.
If you remember, Voda continued, last week's class had to be canceled because we were so busy. I do remember now, said the dispatcher, and I said you could hold the class as soon as we had some free time. And the first free time, said Voda, is this morning. You see, it was Fodak's job to hold regular safety classes for the tugs, and he was an expert on signal flags. Thanks for reminding me, Fodak. So the tugs gathered for signal flag class out in the harbor. In the busy world of the harbor, it is important that all ships can talk to each other in an emergency by showing colored signal flags. The flags are like special words that ships say to each other. The signals help prevent accidents.
Let's get started, said Fodak. I will show one of the signal flags and ask someone to tell me what it means.
George, who didn't seem to be listening.
All right, said Fodak, showing the first signal flag. What does this flag mean? Emily?
That flag means... Emily paused, thinking. I am leaving for the ocean.
Right, said Fodak. It does mean I am leaving for the ocean.
Fodak showed a different flag.
What does this signal mean?
He said.
Theodore?
Let me think, said Theodore. I think it means I'm dragging my anchor.
Very good, said Fodak. Let's try another one, said Fodak as he showed a new flag. What does this signal mean? George?
Hmm? Said George, when he was surprised to hear his own name. Go ahead, George, said Theodore, trying to be encouraging. Tell Fodak what the flag means.
I will,
said George. But he wasn't sure at all what the flag meant. No, I know, called Hank.
Give George a minute to think, said Fodak. This signal means I am in trouble, said Fodak. George, you really need to know this one.
These signal flags are silly, said George.
We haven't looked at the other signals yet, called Fodak, who had raised another flag. This is a very important signal.
What does that flag mean?
This signal flag means danger, stay away, replied Fodak.
My brain is sore from memorizing all those signals, said Hank.
I know what you mean, laughed George. Fodak's class gives me a pain in the head, too.
But George was the only one laughing. Over the next few days, the tugs were very busy as many large ships entered and left, and many barges were pushed and pulled. But not once during the week did one of the tugs use the signal flags. And George made sure Fodak knew it.
Did you use any of your signal flags today, Fodak?
Asked George.
No,
said Fodak, who didn't really like the question.
His tugs.
To run a fleet of tugs, you have to be prepared.
Lady, Hercules, here, wait. Stay right where you are. There's an order.
Hello.
Upstart civilian. I'll get you in a naval convoy one day and I'll teach you a lesson or two. And then you know what orders are all about.
Yuck, that blue nose. He's orders mad. Orders come before common sense in naval terms.
I better Barney with him too, Hercules. Keep those boys in line, he shouts. As if I haven't done this job every naval exercise.
I'll check them after I've done my inspection.
We should work together, not fight each other. Never fought when I was a young tug.
Ahoy there! Ahoy there! You! Oi, you! Red thing! Collect some fire barges and proceed to the fire practice area now!
I'm standing by, waiting for orders to proceed to the old dock.
And those orders are cancelled, and I'm in charge. Fire practice now, and I don't leave it till I tell you. Do I make myself clear? And now move, faster they flame, faster they flame.
Aye, aye, sir.
Right, Starfleet, we're on servicing naval manoeuvres again. OJ's laying marker buoys in the old dock area.
Hey, oi, you, come back here. Oi, you just scraped it again. Oi! Zedstacks are bad enough, but Bluno, oh, he's something else.
Night came down fast.
Dock lights help Big Mickey transfer explosives to the naval tramper Krakatoa. Tanks were moored off. All were shot of their dangerous loads except Zoran, now being unloaded. One last-minute slip-up could mean disaster.
I'll be glad to get rid of this lot.
Attention! Attention!
Oh, no, here we go.
Hey, I'm coming alongside. Move aside. You with a circle on your funnel, move!
Ain't what mean me, mister, do you?
Yeah, you, mister. Move that barge. My load's first.
You shouldn't move a barge that's being unloaded.
Get pension off, old-timer. This is my pool, eh? See what goes.
Yeah.
Go and draw your pension, OJ, you bastard.
Shut it, the paddler's right. We're not moving that barge, mister.
I want this fuel unloaded now. Hey, you, Gorky, drop your hook into this baby. Hey, leave the munitions. Wait your turn.
Watch him.
Yeah, I'm coming alongside. This barge has to be unloaded. I've got orders too.
Whose orders?
Captain Starr's orders. I'm coming alongside.
Ha ha, we'll see about that. Now just move aside and let me through.
Bruno, stay back. That barge is unsafe.
Do not give me orders. If I want to move, I move. I told you to move there. Now look what's happened.
You dummy.
Oh no.
Start engines, quick.
I'm in charge. Stay where you are.
No way. I know what's on that barge. Get clear. The whole thing's gonna blow.
Stay where you are.
Emergency, emergency. Clear the area immediately.
They still ain't obey order.
Move.
He's got himself into this. Leave him.
It's too dangerous, 10 cents.
You're coming with me, Blue Nose.
Keep going, 10 cents. Keep going.
Do you move me? They've got my orders, and their orders says I am loading fuel out.
You can load all you want after I get you out of here. Hey, OJ, what shall I do with him?
Put him at the back. Out the way. We don't want any more of his orders.
Why? This is a mutiny. Take me back immediately. Obey orders. Obey orders. Orders is orders.
Oh, no. Big Mickey's dock is going up.
Oh. Big Mickey!
Oh, he's done it. He's falling sideways.
Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Cook.
Cook.
We're gonna play.
Kiara, we ask 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
She will defend you.
That'll never happen. Okay, defend him, yeah. Celeste, 100 married men, name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Clean.
Clean. Terry?
Yes, sir.
Leave me alone. Quit coming over here. Terry? Talk to 100 married men. Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Well, financially. You should pay more
bills. I told you. Name something your mother-in-law could do to make you like her more.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Stop telling me how to run my
Stop
house.
Stop telling me how to run my damn house.
Welcome, everybody. I never saw guys in such a hurry to get to their seats. Ready to go? Sandy, I'm going to start with you, and I'm going to have you look at this monitor right here where we're about to see David.
The most disgusting thing my wife ever cooked was...
Now, I stopped the tape there, because for 10 points, I want you to finish his sentence.
Shrimp with pasta?
Shrimp with pasta? All right.
Salmon.
I never cooked salmon!
You cooked it the other night. David.
I didn't tell you how bad it was. I acted like, because you liked it so much.
What was wrong with it?
I don't know, several pairs of, I don't know.
Several pairs of underwear.
I don't know.
Polyester shirt.
Polyester shirt.
I don't even know that.
Yeah, I mean,
I didn't know.
How embarrassing if he owns several pairs of underwear.
I don't know.
Janine, here's Michael.
The part of my body my wife finds most irresistible is...
Hey.
His lips.
His lips.
My little man.
I'm speechless.
Me too.
Okay. Well, go figure. All right, we're going to turn things around here and see if you can make some points turning the other way around. So, Michael, here's Janine.
My husband is in love with his...
Oh.
Mom.
Well, now that's very sweet.
Mom moves, so I have the dually.
Yeah, right, right. I just wonder how many euphemisms you can have for that. My mom, I never thought of that. All right, Monty, here's Vita.
My husband thinks he's an expert at...
working a remote control on the television.
All right.
Barbecue.
You're good at barbecue.
That you and Sandy had a very stormy honeymoon?
That's right. We went to Cancun, and we got hit by Hurricane Roxanne. And they evacuated us to a dive with 10 people in a room, 2 beds, and nobody spoke English.
Absolutely. Well, Monty took me shopping for rings. Actually, it was like window shopping. So we're just going to look at rings to find out which one I like. And then Monty saw one he liked, so he put it right on my finger and he purchased it right on the spot.
Jeannie works on a radio station as a radio personality, and I found out one of her favorite balladeers was going to be on the station. So I got in touch with his people and the station and made arrangements to show up there. And
Well, Will Downing asked me to sing a part of the song. And he said, if you sing this song, I promise it'll be the most memorable day of your life. And I did. Then he says, turn around.
With you.
Okay.
If you told Michael you were going to have lunch with an old flame, would he be furious, curious, or seated at the next table?
Furious.
Michael?
Seated at the next table.
Uh-huh. Gonna keep an eye on you.
Furious?
He might be furious too, though.
I couldn't imagine her going with somebody else on a, you know, date like that. So I figured if she did, she'd want me right there with her.
Vida, if you could dress Monty up for a sexual fantasy, did he? She's so willing to hear these jokes.
I need to learn how to play pool, as a matter of fact, and he promised to show me how to play pool.
Well, I was thinking this was a pool boy, like, you know,
no,
the guy
pool
that...
table.
Oh, see, I was thinking shooting a pool boy with the skimmer, you know, this kind of action.
No, shooting pool and bending over.
Okay, all right, good. You got it right. Who might argue? Sandy, after your last little spat, which Hitchcock movie did David say you most resembled? Stranger on a Train, Frenzy, or Psycho?
Definitely Psycho.
All right! David, maybe you should tell. How was she Psycho?
Well, whenever we get in an argument, maybe not the last argument, but she goes off the handle pretty good and does some pretty drastic things. Not drastic, but she drove off one time and drives back.
Don't talk about that.
Yeah. And then she drives off again.
But I am normal.
Right. Just when she gets mad next time, don't, or only when you get caught.
I would have to say sometimes.
No, Vida? Honey. Only when you get caught. Because, you know, like when your father thinks you're wrong and, you know, all that. So
it means, you know, sometimes you think I'm wrong, you know. You try and correct me.
You're right.
Okay, see?
Michael, did Jeannie say...
75 years later.
As I reveal their secrets, if you think it's your wife I'm talking about, I want you to hold up that sign that you now have to your left. Hold it up, and I want to see it right now. You're going to get my attention by yelling out,
That's my wife!
Right. Now, if you're correct, you're going to get 10 points. But you got to be smart, because if you're not right, you're going to lose 10 points. The first one up is the only one that can win or lose. You ready?
Ready.
Here's the first one. She could eat an entire package of barbecue chips. All by herself. Who was that? Sandy. Guys, one thing to learn, there's never such a thing as enough.
Oh my God.
That's right.
She secretly wears your underwear.
That's my wife.
Yes. Vida? Why?
I do, because I like his boxers.
And I just... boxers, because they're comfortable.
But what he doesn't know is that I wear his new ones, too, when he's not at home sometimes.
Oh, you do?
Uh-huh.
She likes being on top.
That's my wife.
When she catches you in a lie, she loves to watch you squirm. Who was that?
Well. 2 hours later.
Today's winners will spend a week in the exotic South Seas of Micronesia aboard the luxurious liveaboard dive yacht, the Truk Aggressor 2. Operated by Live Dive Pacific, the Truk Aggressor 2 will show you the Pacific's most fascinating collection of underwater wrecks. Back to you, Gary.
Thank you, Ellen. All right. Very nice. Now, the way things stand right now, Sandy and David, you have 20 points. Give yourself a hand. That's good. Two correct answers. Vita and Monty, you also have 20 points.
All right.
Woo! Uh-oh. I hate those cups.
What is going on up there?
I hate those cups.
Cups?
All's well that ends well, hey fellas?
Vera! Help! Hey! Vera!
What?
Oh. Hit the button!
Hang on, baby!
Oh, no! Hit the button!
What? I can't hear you!
Hit the button!
Oh!
Oh, no! Not that button! Other button! That's it!
Hi, Mommy.
Shut up, Vera.
Well, okay, I'm just trying to...
Shut up, you moron.
Hey, I'm no moron, you jerk.
Shut up, you bag. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with you? I'm no bag. And you know what? You ain't no genius.
Vera, honey.
No, don't Vera, honey, me.
Vera. Vera, honey.
Oh, honey, me.
Pumpkin. Pumpkin.
Open bookshelf. Open book bar. Open book bar shelving.
Open sesame.
That's stupid.
Whoa!
Stupid now, stupid.
Hey, come on. Just get off me.
Sesame.
Stop sesame.
Christmas to all, and to all a good night.
Good night.
It's stuck on something.
Something supernatural.
Oh, shut up. Go help her.
Go on.
Come on. Screwing around. Jessica, circle the perimeter of the house. See if there's a window open. And you, Mr. President, get into the garage.
The house has a mind of its own.
Unlike someone I know.
Oh!
One.
Wait.
Two. Three.
Ow! Ow!
Stop squirming!
Stop kicking!
Okay, so listen, we just want to talk.
Will you just stop and talk to us?
Please!
There's nowhere to run now, little man.
See ya. Oh no, a ladder. Oh,
you really think I'm that stupid?
Yes, I do.
That's far enough.
Well, hello there.
Enough!
Mushroom slices.
One mushroom slice. Two mushroom slices. Check.
Next, three slices of avocado. One avocado slice, two avocado slices.
Again.
That's only two. We need three. One more.
Three avocado slices. Check. A delicious quesadilla. You do? Oh, show us what you cook, Mr. Noodle. Oh, that's a big empty pot, Mr. Noodle. But what goes in it? A shoe?
A pot isn't for shoes. It's to cook in.
Get your shoe out of the pot, Mr. Noodle. No, no, no. Oh, spaghetti. Yum, yum, yum. Whoa, that's a lot of spaghetti, Mr. Noodle. Wow! And we're waiting. Oh, it's ready! It's cooked! Oh, boy! That's a long noodle, Mr. Noodle! Thanks, Mr. Noodle! Keep learning! And we'll love you! Happy, happy dance, dance! Happy, happy dance, dance! When we learn something new, we do that! Is wondering about today. Wait for it. Wait for it. Counting! Yeah! Whoa! Pretty clouds! Let's count them to see how many there are. Five clouds all together! Yeah! Boy, Elmo loves counting and wants to find out more. Hey! Let's ask Elmo's friend, Smarty. Let's call her together. Oh, Smarty!
Five, four, three. Count down with me, Elmo. Two, one.
Yay! Boy, Smarty sure does love counting.
You've got my number, Elmo.
Boy, Elmo wants to find out more about numbers.
Well, what do we do when we want to learn something new?
We look it up!
Searching for counting. Much fun! And you can do it all sorts of ways. You can count your eyes. One, two.
Starts to really figure it out. I think his minutes go up. The more he affects the game, the more dangerous this UCLA team becomes in terms of the national picture. Doesn't give the foul there. Enigwe missing there, and a stop for the Bruins. It's interesting, they get to the foul line so much, JB, but only a 64% free throw shooting team, which is weird when you're a pretty good three-point shooting team. Nothing wrong with that. Aggies coming off a 79-68 loss to Eastern Washington, in which they ran cold from the three-point line. Tiger calls it up. How UCLA is now? Get back to that point after the break, JB. Actually, JB, since it's Masters Sunday, I'm taking it to break. So if we ratchet it back just a
little. Kez gave a national audience a heavy dose of his drop step and went giving out a weekly award in addition to the Pac-12 honors for Coach of the Week.
Yeah, he got it last week, hands down. I get so. We just reaffirm it here this afternoon that he, in fact, was Coach of the Week last week. Sponsored by nobody.
Don's Daily Starbucks behind that one. Foul down low, and if that's Bonitz, it's
see how sky high are you going to get after beating those two teams on the road.
Bailey over to Jaquez and David Singleton. Single digits left for Campbell on the splits. Couldn't finish.
Goodness. Oh, hello there. We're having a big storm here in the harbor, so I decided to stay late. You know, just make sure everything's all right. You know, on nights like this, the wind is howling and the waves crashing about like this. Many a sailor has said he's seen the Flying Dutchman. The Flying Dutchman is supposed to be a ghost ship. And the story goes that long, long ago, a captain was sailing his ship through a big storm when the others on board said, "Turn around, go back." You know, they were sure they were going to sink. The captain didn't believe them. And then, suddenly, there was a terrible shudder, and the ship snapped in two and was swept to the bottom of the ocean. And they say, on certain stormy nights, you can still see the Flying Dutchman.
10 cents, sunshine. What's the problem? Oops.
Oh, Mario!
Well, for a good funk, my Mikey, come on.
There she is. That's very like the lovely Lily herself.
Those Star Tugs not got any fuel, Lily. They're a disgrace.
Oh, thank you, Zoran. Is that for me?
It's not for you, Lily. It's for Vienna.
Oh, Zoran.
How do you get past that fire barge, 10 cents?
Easy. Here, what's up with you two?
Oh, well, we blocked them up the creek to save the fuel contract for you, Zoran.
We only went for the light barge.
Huh? You idiots! We needed that light here, didn't we? To get Vienna in, for us, as well as for them. Now, what's this about a fire barge? Have you taken one from its station?
Yes, we only jammed it a little way.
Well, get back up there quick before the fire chief gets there.
Fire chief won't be pleased with you two. It'll take them all night to get that fire barge free.
Aye, it will, aye. Mate, they should have thought of that when they jammed it in. Have you always been like this?
My name used to be Captain Harry. That was good then in those days. Then I was sold. They painted out my name and called me Boomer. Ever since then, nothing but trouble.
Boomer was right. 10 cents had set off ahead when, to everyone's amazement, the tow rope unwound and fell into the sea.
Well, how did that happen? Oi, did you do that?
Can't have, can I? It's you that's lost the tow. The rope's still attached to me.
Ah, he's right, 10 cents. That's the first sign of a jinx I've ever seen.
Hey, Sunshine, go pick up the coal barge and we'll try starting him up.
Yes,
Later, when 10 cents and Sunshine had restoked Boomer and got a good head of steam, the big moment arrived.
Okay, Boomer, try your engine now.
Well done, my son.
Well, do you see now?
Pull him out! Pull him out!
Aye, aye, sir.
It was as well for 10 cents that he still had a line on Boomer. With smoke billowing everywhere, it would have been difficult and dangerous to get too close. He pulled him clear of the dock, and strangely, as soon as he was clear, the smoke stopped completely.
How do you do that? The smoke's all gone. Now look!
Told you, Sunshine. Jinxed.
Hey, what the?
That's never happened before, has it?
No. Oh dear. Boomer, I think.
10 cents! Take that tug to Lucky's Yard right this minute. Understand?
Right, sir. Boomer's taking on water.
Hey, Boomer, what's so funny?
I'm thinking just what I wanted.
What? Look, we're going to make it to Lucky's, even if I sink with you.
Cut free, cut free. I'm sinking, save yourselves. Huh?
Oh, well, that's lucky. He's come to rest on that old sunken garbage barge.
Look, you stay here. I'll go and get a rescue crane.
Hey, maybe the jinx has stopped now, eh? You're still afloat.
No, it hasn't. It's still here, all right. I wanted to sink, but instead I land right on...
Be sure to get that barge under Boomer as soon as you can. He's heavy, and I don't want to hold him too long. He's coming up. Full fillies.
Full steam.
You'll be okay now, Boomer.
Yeah, come on, Boomer.
Me horse is jammed. You'll have to take the barge and where Trevor Lloyd is.
Just what I thought would happen. Just what I thought would happen.
Oh, another jinx.
Don't be silly, Sunshine. Moor that barge somewhere and go tell Captain Star. We'll have to try and tow this lot to Lucky's Yard before it gets dark.
Oh, you reckon we will?
Yeah, if we don't get jinxed before we get there.
Hey, I hope you haven't spoken too soon.
Lucky's Yard was ready for them. It was brightly lit up as they approached. Tough construction ready to take Boomer.
Be careful now. You have to guide the cranes so they can lower the tug onto that raft.
Right. Yeah, I see it, OJ. Right, it's up ahead, Sunshine.
Aye.
Steady as she goes.
What's going on? What's all doing?
Get your own lights onto that rig, quick. That's it.
Ah, good.
It's all right. I've got it again, Big Mac. Straight ahead.
Oi!
Oi, don't push! Hard astern! What are you doing?
Working for Captain Zero. He and the Z-Stacks were on the munitions contract.
Good luck, Boomer!
No sooner had 10 Cents tooted his greeting when the munitions barge exploded, much to the Z-Stacks' bewilderment.
See, you can't get rid of a jinx that easily, 10 Cents.
Aye. You do it.
Yeah? Well, I'm going to go and speak to Boomer about it. Look, you're coming.
Oh. Yeah, see it, Boomer. We think we might have solved the problem and we want to try something. Go on, 10 Cents. Do it. Blow twice.
Yeah, well, that was a stupid exercise, Sunshine.
No, it wasn't, 10 Cents. No.
Don't believe it.
Very last moment, Theodore decided to turn and float away. Then Oliver began to chase him. Theodore could almost feel the big tug's bumpers on his back. His engine pounded deep in his hull as he raced away. Now, Theodore is smaller than Oliver, but he's also quick and clever. A rather nervous ship saw the strange tugboat brooming and zooming towards him. He thought it meant to bump right into him. Emily blew her emergency whistle. Well, there was only one thing for Kirby to do. He threw his engines into reverse to back up onto the harbor as fast as he could. But he couldn't avoid the little tug who seemed to be on a collision course for him. Theodore, watch where you're going, said Pearl. At the very last second, Theodore spun around sideways towards Kirby. Why aren't I slowing down? Like George does. Well, luckily, Theodore only nudged Kirby a little bit. But poor Kirby was so frightened, he groaned a terrible groan. And some of his telephone poles rattled overboard right into the harbor. The only good thing about that nudge, I guess, was, well, it got Kirby going, and he headed out to sea, and it looked as if he meant to sail all the way back to England. Emily caught up to Theodore. Oh, hello. You know, I was just thinking about all the fun I had as an officer aboard this ship. Well, that was in the days before I was harbor master here in the big harbor. I remember my old captain. I learned a lot from him. And we were good friends. Well, you know, when you're at sea together for months at a time, you make new friends, and sometimes they become best friends. You know, I've been lucky. Everywhere I've gone, I've made new friends. And today, well, I've got lots of best friends right here in the big harbor. I think we have one of the friendliest harbors in the whole wide world. As a matter of fact, I think friendship is wonderful, don't you? But you know, I remember a time when Theodore was new here. He thought he might have too many best friends.
Emily had just returned from a long trip back across the ocean, from France. Theodore wanted to know all about her trip. Emily told him that when she had first arrived, Theodore was very impressed. Emily, you're my which means her head in French. But after a nap, she was ready for a fête, which means a party. Now Theodore thought tête and fête were terrific sounding words. Emily had been to so many wonderful places and had so many great adventures. Theodore was very impressed. Emily, you're my best friend, he said. Thank you, Theodore, replied Emily. And off she went with the kind of smile you get when someone's made you very happy. Later that same afternoon, Hank was showing Theodore around the harbor. Now with Hank as a tour guide, there's never a dull moment. Let's see who can be first around Bedford Buoy, said Hank. And the two tugs were off before you could say one toot. Hank was the first around Bedford. He was making the fastest turns Theodore had ever seen. Theodore was very impressed. Hank, you're my best friend, he said. Great, said Hank. I've always wanted to have a best friend. Are you sure, Theodore? Sure, I'm sure, replied Theodore.
I'm measuring my desk. 2.5. No, this really is small. I wonder how high it is. Oh, hello there. Oops, no. Well, as you can see, I'm measuring my desk. Let's see how high this is. I don't know. Do you think my desk is too small? I mean, after all, I'm the harbor master here in the big harbor. That's a pretty important job, having such a small desk. Do you think maybe if I had a bigger desk, I'd feel more important? You know, our friend Theodore was wondering about feeling more important just the other day. And then, something very surprising happened to him.
It all began at the morning work meeting. The dispatcher was telling the tugs their jobs for the day.
George and Fodok, the dispatcher began. Today, I have another important job for you. There is an oil super tanker to be brought in. Proceed immediately.
Then the dispatcher turned to Theodore and Hank.
Today, you'll be replacing broken marker buoys. That is all.
Hank set off cheerfully, but Theodore began to feel a little bothered. See, he wanted the kind of job that George and Fodok had. I wish I could have a more important job, Theodore said to himself. The old town clock on Citadel Hill tolled midnight. Somewhere, a lone Canada goose cried its haunting cry, flying south ahead of the icy winds of winter. The tugs were sound asleep at the great ocean tug and salvage company dock. The water was getting chillier, and they'd snuggled together for warmth. Something was gurgling. Gurgling under the inky sea. Gurgling at first, and then it was bubbling, and from the bubbling began a foaming, which at last became a swirling of something moving towards Theodore. Closer and closer and faster and faster, and from the water came a sea monster. A sea monster roared up from the dampy deep. Oh, it had bugly eyes and big batty wings to carry a tug down to its sea monster lair, far, far beneath the waves. Theodore gasped out loud. It woke up Emily. Theodore was moving Barrington Barge. He loves pulling the flat-bottomed friendly barges to and from each shore. But more importantly, pulling barges helped Theodore prepare for getting his V word. So when Theodore became a V, he would be allowed to leave the harbor and go off across the ocean, pulling ships all around the world. Theodore was certainly getting to be a very good barge puller. Well, on that day, they were passing the sandy beach. Theodore thought there was something strange about that beach, but
he wasn't sure just what it was. Now, Theodore's favorite place in the whole harbor is the Great Ocean Tug and Salvage Dock.
Good to see you, buddy. Dream Car Week. Fantastic. I love you, Mama May! Dream Car Week! Dream Car Week!
Yeah.
George, let's get this Dream Car Show started with the first prize up for bids today on The Price is Right.
We're going to kick things off with Devin and new vehicle entertainment systems. These 12.4-inch car monitors can be easily connected to Wi-Fi and feature two quality 5-watt speakers.
So they go to whoever gets closest to the actual retail price without going over. We're going to start with you, Robert. Go ahead.
$550.
$550, Brianna.
To say $530.
$530, Destin.
$350.
$350. Come on up here, Robert. Welcome to the show, man. Yay. Nice to meet you.
Yes.
I've waited a lifetime to come into. Well, no more waiting for you,
no
Robert.
More. I'm here.
Not only did you come down, but you stepped on up to the main stage to win this. Go ahead, George.
It's your new SUV! It's the Lincoln Corsair, featuring a 2-liter engine.
0 or 8, place it down here. It's like that, all the way down. Now, if you don't get the price the first time, all you have to do is have one number right, and you can play another round. And if you have, on the second round, if you have at least one number right, you can play a third round. Always have to have at least one number right. Ready,
all
Robert?
Right, all right.
Go get them. 2 or 4 for the first number. Lincoln Corsair. 2. 5, 0, or 8. An 8. 3, 8, 7, or 6. 3, 7, 9, 1, 6, or 5. 6. And 1, 5, 4, 0, 3, or 7. 0. All right, Robert, right back there. $60. Is he right? All he still needs one. $40,000. Robert, man. We're going to get another contestant up here. We're here for the whole hour. Don't go anywhere. We're really trying to give this away. Let's get another contestant down here, George. Who you got?
Taylor Bradford, come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Welcome to the show, Taylor. Good luck. Next prize, please, George.
Next, we've got a new refrigerator. This French door refrigerator features 3 temperature settings and a family hub for searching recipes, making grocery lists, and setting calendars.
Wow, nice. Thank you, Rachel. Taylor, you're first.
$2,600.
$2,600. Brianna.
$4,500.
$4,500. Good luck. Dustin.
I'm going to go with $2,200.
$2,200. $2,600,
$4,500,
$2,200. $1. $1. Actual retail price is $2,699. Taylor. No!
That's okay.
Well, you got another refrigerator.
Yeah.
Yeah, your mom just bought one, so now I have another one. And you're going to spin the wheel later on. We'll be right back, folks. Quick commercial. Don't go away. Welcome back, everybody. Dream Car Week. Exciting day. George Gray, let's get somebody else down here. Who's that?
All right. How about Arthur Marujo? Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Welcome to the show. Good luck to you. Next prize, please.
Next up, we've got designer shoes. This Ferragamo shoe collection features 2 pairs of leather driving loafers for him, plus 2 pairs of leather shoes for her.
Arthur, go ahead, you're first.
Let's go $1,900, Duke.
$1,900. Thank you, good luck, Brianna.
$2,400.
$2,400. Thank you so much, Dustin.
$1,700.
$1,700. Thank you. Liberty.
I'm going to go with
1901. My 01s aren't paying.
Actual retail price is $2,800. Brianna, come on up here.
Also entering this match, three teams will be starting things off, and then at regular intervals, a new trio will enter with the
left. Cassidy, this ring.
Chris, do you believe that people need to have what they want? Or what is this their slogan here, these guys?
The slogan that we're the best friends that we could ever have. What's the slogan?
What's it? Ex-Cotter, help us out.
You got to give the people what they want.
You got to give the people what they want, Chris.
You never give the people what they want because the people don't know what they want. I know what they want.
They want a fireball to the face?
That's...
Tubby toes.
Be a hero, huh? Well, what do you think of this?
Yeah, that's it, kid.
What?
I taught him that. Ka-chow!
A three-way battle for the lead with 10 to go.
It's time.
I don't believe it!
That was the fastest pit stop I've ever seen.
It was a great stop, but he's still got to beat that race car out.
It's going to be close.
Yay! Back in the race!
Kiddo.
Got four turns left, one at a time. Drive it in deep and hope it sticks. Go!
Lightning McQueen is going to win the Piston!
I am not coming in behind you again, old man!
At Center Cup, that says car. We will give you 5 seconds to do that. But now I'll give you a chance to win up to 15 more seconds, giving you a grand total of 20 seconds. Here's how. On this board, we have four items. We have two turtle doves, 12 swans a-singing, 5 golden rings, and 10 lords a-leaping. Now what I want you to tell me is which of these gifts are from the Christmas song.
12 swans a singing.
12 swans a singing.
Oh!
No, sir. Ball, you can do this.
I do, I like this.
Let's go down and get your car. Now, it's only 10 seconds. I will give you $500 to not play. No! 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1! Christian, you did it! You got the car! Go get your car, Christian!
Oh my God! Oh my God.
Holly, look. We have to work on these a little bit.
Really?
So, you each have $1,000.
Oh, well, I know I do, so...